Hi and welcome! In this video, we will learn how to use TextMesh Pro's link tag in a way that will enable us to invoke events when our text box contains link tagged elements. In the first part, we'll build a system for an all-at-once displayed text, and in the second part, we will see how we can make the system work with the typewriter effect we built in the previous video. The link tag enables you to hook up the contents of your text boxes to other systems of your game. The link tag syntax looks like this. This is the so-called link ID, and this is the link text. I highly recommend using the link ID for everything you need to reference. This is my scene setup. I have two characters with different emotions. They are in a dialogue setting, and I want them to change their displayed emotion based on the contents of their discussion. The first step to achieving this is tagging relevant parts of our conversation with link tags corresponding to the emotions I want them to display. So, for example, happy, sad, and neutral. Also, this script is set up in a way that it sends a new chunk of text to a text box when I click my left mouse button. First, let's have a look at the static system. By this, I mean that all of your text is being displayed in one chunk. We'll create a new class and call it LinkEventInvoker. It needs to know about the text box, and because we will base the system on events, we will create one with a string parameter as well. In Awake, we will get the TMP text component and store a reference of it. Our main function is going to be called CheckForLink. Because this script should check our text box's content every time it changes, we will subscribe and unsubscribe to the TMP Pro Event Manager's text changed event, like this in onEnable and onDisable. We get red squiggly lines, which tell us something's missing. In this case, we need our CheckForLink method to take an object as its parameter. This being fixed, the squiggle vanishes. First thing we need to do is to check if our text box contains any links at all. Link count tells us how many we can expect. If the result is zero, we'll return out of the method. If it is not, we will run a for loop for as many links as we found in our text. In there, we will get a link info, which contains all the needed infos about our found links like the ID, the text, and more. Afterwards, let's invoke our event with the link ID. Before we'll have a look at the listener to the event, let's see how we need to change the code to enable it being used with the typewriter effect. That's the one that reveals the text one character at a time. We created this one in my previous tutorial. Because, at least in my projects, I either have the text visible all at once or have a typewriter enabled, I'll create a second script for this to keep things tidy. The code is almost the same. We will just need to check if the current text box's max visible characters are equal to the link text first character index. That's this character index. If it is, we will invoke our event. Because there can hardly be any more link text first characters at the same position, we will add a break at this point. That's it for checking and invoking. Now let's have a look at how the receiver might look like. Seeing as this tutorial is about sending events when stuff gets revealed in your text box, I will stick to a simple implementation. I prepared this script to switch images out to something else. And I'm choosing to use a switch statement for that. Our event sends out a string containing the link ID, so just make sure you have stuffed React based on the ID. And this is how our system works now. As mentioned in here, I was using a simple switch to check for the IDs, but I recommend using a bigger system if you want much more to interact with these events. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you did, please give it a like and subscribe. Which systems are you going to implement with this? Tell me in the comments, I'd love to know. Have a great week!